I was born and raised in Mali, West Africa, from a low-class family.
I was born in Chittagong, Bangladesh, which is one of the commercial capital. But my father was from a very, very poor village and a very poor family in Bangladesh.
Everything was pretty much limited, so it was tough. Tough growing up.
Lack of energy everywhere, lack of problem with lighting, students having no access to electricity.
And I had to pretty much study under kerosene lights and candle lamp.
And which were very harmful to the lungs and the eyes as well.
But I didn't have access to anything better. That was the only choice I had.
What we have actually developed at June Energy is that it's basically a handheld device that utilizes clean solar energy, stores it in a battery, and provides light at night through clean lighting LEDs, and also has a port on the side where you can actually plug in your any cell phone that you have, and it will actually help charge your cell phone so people at nighttime can talk and keep in touch with family back in their villages. Kerosene lamps, if you look at it, provide 60 lumens of light, which is really not much. That's why it strains the eyes. Whereas our product, we're looking to maybe give sufficient lighting above 100 lumens, which is really ample for reading at nighttime and provides a good surface area so students can read.
Currently, we're in a final revision of our beta product. On my business card, my role in June Energy, I'm the Chief Technical Officer. But we're pretty much, everyone does everything, so I guess it's kind of a loose title. We've built a fully functional prototype, and we've done a rapid prototype for the mechanical design of it. And now we're just working on getting costs down, actually. Our target price for our target customers, which are the people in these developing areas, is around $15 or so.
We were traveling back and forth to the Ross Business School, having MBA students from there. We went to the medical school. We went to talk to the health officials who've told us, like, hey, you know, this energy problem, it's in healthcare too, because hospitals in rural areas of Africa, our hospitals can't operate at night because there's no lighting.
Our initial market might be Engineers Without Borders, Peace Corps volunteers. The military is a possibility. Pretty much anywhere. Any type of situation where you're in an area without electricity, you know, in a remote area like hiking trips and things like that. I'm really excited about our upcoming venture in Singapore to get more involved with the manufacturing process.
So our next step is to make a second trip to Africa.
We're definitely going to go to Kenya in the next 1 to 2 months to really understand how people live there, what are the problems they're really facing, and how our solution can be tailored to meet and solve their problems.
I'm excited already because I think the dream is coming into reality.
As of a couple weeks ago, we were just offered over $500,000 of venture capital investment, so we're really excited about that as well.
Since I was 11, I had that mentality. I want to do engineering so I can give something back to the society.
It's about helping people. I'm not happy with the way other people are living. Like I see things that are happening, and I don't think they should live that way. You know. And so it's just being, you know, making a stride towards changing that.